Hi everybody, it's Mr. D, and we're back for another story time. Today our theme is going to be dragons. And before we get started, there's a couple things you're gonna need. You're gonna need a bean bag or something you can toss up and catch. And you're gonna need something you can shake, like a little shaky egg. All right. Now let me show you the sign word of the day, which is dragon. This one's pretty fun, because you hold up your hands in front of your mouth like this, and then you wiggle your fingers and push your hands out. So, like this, like you're breathing flames like an actual dragon. All right, pretty cool, huh? All right, well, let's get started with our first book. And this one is called Dragons Love Tacos by Adam Rubin. All right, here we go. Hey kid, did you know that dragons love tacos? They love beef tacos and chicken tacos. They love really big, gigantic tacos and tiny little baby tacos as well. Why do dragons love tacos? Maybe it's the smell from the sizzling pan. Maybe it's the crunch of the crispy tortillas. Maybe it's a secret. Either way, if you want to make friends with a dragon, tacos are key. Hey dragon, why do you guys love tacos so much? But wait, as much as dragons love tacos, they hate spicy salsa even more. They hate spicy green salsa and spicy red salsa. They hate spicy chunky salsa and spicy smooth salsa. If the salsa is spicy at all, the dragons can't stand it. Why do dragons hate spicy salsa? Well, just one drop of hot sauce makes a dragon's ears smoke. Just one single speck of hot pepper makes a dragon snort sparks. Spicy salsa gives dragons the tummy troubles, and when dragons get tummy troubles, oh boy. If you want to make tacos for dragons, keep the toppings mild. Tomatoes, lettuce, cheese, those are all good toppings when making tacos for dragons. Hey dragon, how do you feel about spicy taco toppings? Dragons love parties. They like costume parties and pool parties. They like big, gigantic parties with accordions and tiny little parties with charades. Why do dragons love parties? Maybe it's the conversation. Maybe it's the dancing. Maybe it's the comforting sound of a good friend's laughter. The only thing dragons love more than parties or tacos is taco parties. Taco parties are parties with lots of tacos. If you want to have some dragons over for a taco party, you'll need buckets of tacos, pants loads of tacos. The best way to judge is to get a boat and fill the boat with tacos. That's about how many tacos dragons need for a taco party. After all, dragons love tacos. Hey dragon, are you excited for the big taco party? Just remember, dragons hate spicy salsa. Before you host your taco party with dragons, get rid of all the spicy salsa. In fact, bury the spicy salsa in the backyard so the dragons can't find it. These dragons love your taco party. They love the music, they love the decorations, they especially love the tacos. Congratulations! It's a good thing you got rid of all that spicy. Uh-oh, wait a second. What are those little green things in the salsa? You didn't read the fine print? Now with spicy jalapeno peppers? Uh-oh. Dragons, listen to me. Do not eat those tacos. Those little green specks in the salsa, those are jalapeno peppers. They are super spicy. I know you love tacos, dragons, but you're not gonna love those tacos. Do not let the dragons eat those tacos. Uh-oh. Crunch, crunch, crunch. Too late. Oh no, dragons, spewing fire. Uh-oh, look what happened to the house. Why would dragons help you rebuild your house? Maybe they're good Samaritans. Maybe they feel bad for wrecking it. Maybe they're just in it for the taco breaks. After all, dragons love tacos. And that's the end. All right, good job, everybody. Okay, well, get out your beanie bag and stand up, because the first song we're doing is a beanie bag dance. Here we go. We're doing the Beanie Bag Dance.
Put your beanie bag on your head now. Spread your arms way out wide. Put your beanie bag on your head now. And make your whole body glide. With your beanie bag on your head now. Everybody shout it now.
We're doing the Beanie Bag Dance. We're doing the Beanie Bag Dance. We're doing the Beanie Bag Dance. We're doing a Beanie Bag Dance. Everybody. Okay, well now we're gonna do our zoom 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 song. So for those of you who haven't done it before, it's pretty easy. You just go zoom 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 and then you're gonna climb aboard your rocket ship. Alright, is everybody ready? All right, here we go. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. Climb aboard my rocket ship if you want to take a trip. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off. All right, good work. All right, well now we got another classic, Wheels on the Bus. So let's get going. Good work, everybody. Awesome. All right, we have a seat because we're going to do our next book. And this one is called How to Draw a Dragon by Douglas Florian. Here we go. Drawing dragons isn't hard. Drag a dragon to your yard. Dragons may be large in size. You'll need lots of art supplies. Dragons, when they wake, are grumpy, and their heads are rather bumpy. Soothe your dragon with a song as you draw his teeth so long. Careful when you draw each claw. Dragons also love to draw. Draw your dragon's pointed spines using lots of jagged lines. While your dragon's laying eggs, take the time to draw her legs. Dragons have large knobby knees, and it rains when dragons sneeze. While you both ride on your bike, you can draw your dragon's spikes. Draw your dragon's wings in flight, but don't look down and hold on tight. Draw your dragon's bearded chin while he plays the violin. Draw your dragon's bulging eyes as she's watching dragonflies. Dragon fire has reds and yellows, and it's good to toast marshmallows. Time for dragons now to fly. Give a hug and then wave goodbye. All those dragons had to go. But your drawings, ooh, in a show. And that's the end. All right, good job, everybody. Excellent. All right, well, get ready and grab your shake egg or whatever you got. We're about to do a fun song. It's called Shake Our Sillies Out. All right, let's go.
Yawn, my sleepy's out. Yawn, my sleepy's out. Yawn, my sleepy's out. And wiggle through my windows on the way. I gotta shake my sillies out. Shake my sillies out. Shake my sillies out. And wiggle all my windows on the way. And wiggle all my windows on the way.
All right, good job, everybody. Okay. Well, we got another song to do, and this one is called Superhero Camp. Now, for those of you who haven't done this before, you do a couple of things. You need thumbs up, elbows back, feet apart, and tongue out. All right, is everybody ready? All right, here we go. Superhero camp. Superhero camp. Thumbs up. Superhero camp. Superhero camp. Thumbs up. Elbows back. Superhero camp. Superhero camp. Thumbs up. Elbows back. Feet apart. Superhero camp. Superhero camp. Thumbs up. Elbows back. Feet apart. Tongue out. Superhero camp. All right. Good job, everybody. All right. One more song to finish off story time. And we're going to wave and sing goodbye. Is everybody ready? Here we go. We wave and sing goodbye. We wave and sing goodbye. With our friends at story time. We wave and sing goodbye. We clap and sing goodbye. We clap and sing goodbye. With our friends at story time. We clap and sing goodbye. We stomp and sing goodbye. We stomp and sing goodbye. With our friends at story time. We stomp and sing goodbye. Excellent. All right. Well, I hope everybody enjoyed the story time, and we'll see you next time.